For a long time, Uganda's education system had struggled with a job-seeking curriculum, which many have criticized. This compelled the National Curriculum Development Center and other partners to review the O-level curriculum and make it competency-based. After the success of the revised O-level curriculum, the NCDC has revealed that their next step is the A-level curriculum. Grace Baguma, the NCDC Executive Director, reveals that they intend to include leadership training, voluntary work, and vocational skilling in the A-level curriculum.
So we want to bring out a leader. We want to bring out a seasoned person after A-level, and a person who is patriotic and loves his country. You must love your country. You don't know the beauty of belonging to a country. People who have been in exile as refugees know what it means. The sense of belonging, love for your country, the protection of your country. Those are some of the elements, but we are going through approval process for the A-level. We shall be talking to the press in detail after we have been approved by the different organs of government.
The old curriculum focused on academic achievement and promotion to the next class, which left out many learners. Examinations and the grading system did not cater for a wide range of abilities, and many learners did more crumb work. However, Dr. Baguma explains that the new A-level curriculum will also give a chance to learners to explore talents without focusing on their academic ability.
New paradigm in the way assessment should be done. Let us not look at about a person in terms of, hey, how many grades did you get? No. We want to see, oh, how are you able to solve a problem in your community? Are you able to be creative and innovative, and you are coming with something new on the table? That is when we shall begin to respect you as an educated person. So it should not be assessment, assessment, and assessment. Let our community, let our parents shift. It's a paradigm shift from wanting grades to wanting a person.
Of the child or of the learner. And I'm also glad that through what we do, first of all, we emphasize the aspect of gender-responsive pedagogy. We know that in the classroom, there are learners with different learning abilities. We know that in some of the schools or communities, the community is meant to believe that what the boy child can do, the girl child cannot do. We have teachers sitting in the classroom and saying, "Well, you're just a girl." Or they tell them, "If chemistry is hard, why don't you try English?" I think from the recently released PLE results, we also recognize that the girls excelled in English, but then the boys excelled in science.
Meanwhile, the National Curriculum Development Center has partnered with Business Friends Africa, a non-government organization, to organize a 2-day conference on quality education accountability. This will assess the challenges in the education sector, as well as come up with lasting solutions to the challenges.
Empowered. A person who lacks self-esteem. But if a student is empowered, he or she has innate qualities which cannot be deprived for innate qualities of being able to choose between what is right and what is good. And it is on those innate qualities that we build so that we don't derail these children and allow them to go into behaviors that are not warranting the development.
Story by Rachel Nachwala for the news.